Hey guys, today we're going to be making this small three-piece Christmas tree ornament. This one is made of purple heart, hard maple and purple heart. The one we're making today, I think we'll switch the colors around. We'll do a walnut core and a hard maple top and bottom. Going to finish it off with some CA finish over the whole thing. So I'll bring you guys in closer and let's get started. All right, let's go. The only thing we have to be careful of here is we've got a very small area and a very large skew, so we want to be careful not to hit that chuck. Use the parting tool and just kind of get it laid out a little bit. Go an inch, inch and a quarter long. Don't want to cut it too shallow. Switch back to the gouge. We'll just get it a little bit smaller. Really be any shape. I know I always tell people make it about like an apple, but it could be elongated, longer, shorter. Just play around with it, do whatever you like. It's going to be the top, a little larger over here and a little smaller over here. I know it's the opposite of what I normally tell people. Normally tell people make the smallest side always to your right, but this is, even the smallest side on this is still going to be really stout, so I'm not really all that worried about it. And we're kind of getting a lot of that shape that I'd like. This skew is really dull. I'm gonna have to sharpen it. All right, so let's try to sand this a little bit. Again, I normally start at about 120 and work my way up. I think I want to round over these two corners a little bit more, and then we'll swap out that live center. Yeah, I think so. Thank you. Okay, not looking too bad. A little bit finer. All right, I think we're pretty good right there. Let's part this off. Again, angle in a little bit. Bring this in a little closer. All right. Swap the center out quick. Put in chuck, and we'll find a drill bit to put in here. All right, so I think this is a 5/16. This is a brad point. It's just one that I grabbed. Okay, I always tighten up these chucks from two different locations. Move this a lot closer. Now we're going to try to move this in. Keep it moving because we're spinning pretty fast for this drill bit. Kind of watching how far we've gone out here. I think we should be good. All right. We'll go ahead. Part it off. Let's remove this drill bit. Just don't want your hand to hit it accidentally. All right. Put a little CA finish on here, and then we'll go ahead and part it off. I was just folding a new spot in the paper towel. Take a look, it's three coats. Give it one more coat. Okay. Looks pretty good. All right. There we go. All right. All right, guys, we went ahead and swapped out a chunk of walnut for a piece of hard maple. We took out Jacob's chuck, put in our regular live center, got everything set up again. So let's go ahead and round this thing out. All right, let's say up here is where we'll... That's where we're gonna cut our tendon, our little peg at 5/16, and we'll shape it out from there. Don't really know what we want this to look like. We'll try to get the length established first. We'll say that'll be the tip down there. Maybe we'll put a small bead there and a small bead in the middle. Maybe we'll just taper it down. I don't know. We'll see. You know what? Let's make this longer. I don't like that right there. Put about 2/3 of a slope down here. The small shoulder here. Let's see. Move that shoulder, put a little flat right here. Just keep working on it, see if we find something we like. Okay. Oh, very lightly. Now we may have to change the size of this. I think it's going to be too big. Okay, this is going to be the base. We want it to be just larger than that. It's actually pretty close. Still a couple flats. We'll finish getting rid of the flats and call it good. Very small. Small one in here too to match. Working this down a little smaller.
All right.
There we go. We're almost there. It's a little bit thick right here, I think. That feels a lot better. Try some CA finish on there. Try to find a new spot in the paper towel. One last time. Call it good. Okay. Let's go ahead and take our calipers. Okay, we're gonna have to get this down to 5/16. So we get a little tenon on the end of it. And we're down to the last part. Very close. Pretty good right there. Okay, there we go. Let's get our next piece mounted up. All right, we got our next piece chucked up. This one's pretty easy. Normally I just make it look a lot like a pawn piece for a chessel, for a chess set. So I'll show you again here. Like I said, normally it looks a lot like a pawn piece, so we'll try to make this top part. Round it out. We'll try to cut this off right away. Let's say it's gonna be the top of it. It's gonna be the round top part. Little angle piece. We'll taper it out to a base somewhere in here.